Section 12.3 is continued here. Every square matrix with a real number with real number elements has a number associated with it. The number is its determinant. And if we have matrix A, which is A, B, C, D, the determinant A, we write D, E, T, A, and say the determinant of A. So the determinant of this matrix, we take A times D minus B times C. Take note on page 784, talks about determinants of 2x2s and 3x3 matrices. So the determinant of a 2x2 matrix, we take A times D minus B times C. A times D minus B times C. The determinant of a 3x3 matrix here gets a little bit more, not complicated, but more. We're still going to multiply down angles. What we did here, guys, is we took these two rows, or sorry, those two columns, and rewrote them over here just to be able to see it a little bit better. Okay. Now we're going to multiply down plus multiply down plus multiply down. Then we are going to multiply this way. So it's easier to see if we have these rows here rather than looping. So instead of taking C1 times these two, it's easier to see if we just line them up that way. Again, you don't have to every time, but it does help keep it organized. So, a big thing here is to make sure you add up those first before we subtract. So, determinants here. Following determinants, we take 3 times 5 minus negative 1 times 2. Sorry. 15 minus, here we get negative 2, so we end up getting 17. Again, here I'm going to rewrite those first two columns just to make it a little bit easier to see what I'm doing. Now, I need to multiply down 1 times 4 times 2 plus 0 times negative 1 times 3 plus negative 2 times 0 times 5 minus I'm going to start the other direction. Negative 2 times 4 times 3 plus 1 times negative 1 times 5 plus 0 times 0 times 2. Here, I get 8 plus 0 plus 0, which is just 8. Here, I get negative 24 minus 5 plus 0, negative 29. But I'm subtracting a negative 29, which means I'm going to end up adding 29. And I'm going to get 37. Three times five minus six times two. 15 minus 12, 3. So the determinant of our matrix is how we write this equals 3. You have 2 times 0 minus 0 times 3. 0 minus 0 is still just 0. So the determinant of our matrix equals 0. Again, when I get more than 2 by 2, I'd rewrite them just to make it a little bit easier to see. You can wrap around. We can just do 3 times 2 times negative 1. It just gets a little bit more complicated to look at. So it's helpful if we rewrite them. And go down, 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 and back, back, back. So 1 times 4 times 3 plus 0 times 6 times 5 plus 3 times 2 times negative 1. Those are my 3 this way. Now we subtract 3 times 4 times 5 plus 1 times 6 times negative 1 plus 0 times 2 times 3. 12 plus 0 minus 6 gives me 6 minus 60 minus 6 plus 0 gives me 54. 6 minus 54, negative 48. So, the determinant of this matrix here right, determinant of our matrix equals negative 48. We can use determinants to find areas of polygons. We can divide the polygon into triangles and find the area of the triangle. Take note on page 784, the area of the triangle. And here, guys, once we divide them, as long as we divide them into equal triangles, we can just multiply by how many triangles there are. So, the area of a triangle with vertices x1, y1, x2, y2, and x3, y3 is going to be half times the absolute value of the determinant, which is kind of like our base times our height. Okay? And that's because we're taking a base, theoretically, times a height each time. It's just using the determinant to find the real relationship between them. And that determinant is going to be the absolute value. So, one factor in flood safety along a levee is the area that will absorb water should the levee break. The coordinates shown are in miles. What is the area in the picture, the area in the pictured California community on page 785? So, when they built our levee, they had to do planning very similar to this to see if the levee breaks, where's the water going to go? Okay. If we look in the picture on page 785, they've got a triangle kind of this shape. 0, 0, 1.9, 0.4, and 1.4, 2.0. Okay. Before I can find my area, I have to come up with my matrix. Doesn't matter which order you use your points. I'm going to do 1, 2, and 3. So 0, 0. We always put a 1 in the last column. 1.9, 0.4, 1. And then x, y. And there we go. To find our determinant, I rewrite those first two columns. And now I go across diagonally. 0 times 0.4 times 1 plus 0 times 1 times 1.4 plus 1 times 1.9 times 2. Let me get rid of our picture here. For more room. Minus, go the other direction. One times 0.4 times 1.4 plus 0 times 1 times 2 plus 0 times 1.9 times 1. When I go to simplify this, 0, 0, I end up getting 3.8 minus 0.56, 0, and 0. So 0.56. 3.8 minus 0.56 is going to be 3.24. That's just my determinant of A. Now, to find my area, remember, area equals half times the absolute value of our determinant. So, I'm going to take half times, my determinant's already positive. And when I take half of 3.24, I get 1.62. And it doesn't give us the label here. So, 1.62. Maybe it does. It says these are miles. So square miles. Now, what is the area of the triangle with the given vertices? Before we can find our area, we need to find our determinant. Because it's going to be 1/2 the determinant of A. So, set up our matrix. 1, 3, 1. Negative 3, 0, 1, 5, 0, 1. And again, our third column is always just 1s, but we need the third column because it has to be a square matrix in order to find our determinant. I'm going to take and rewrite our first two columns. I'm going to take 1 times 0 times 1 plus 3 times 1 times 5 plus 1 times negative 3 times 0 minus 1 times 0 times 5 plus 1 times 1 times 0 plus 3 times negative 3 times 1. When I go to simplify here, 0, 0, 15, 0, 0, negative 9. So when I take 15 minus negative 9, I actually have a plus 9. So my determinant of A is going to be 24. Now, that's not my final answer. I have to take 1/2 the absolute value of 24, which is just 24, and I'm going to get 12. That's units squared. Let's do one more here. 1, 3, 1, 5, 8, 1, 9, negative 1, 1. 1, 5, 9, 3, 8, 1, negative 1. Down, 1 times 8 times 1, plus 3 times 1 times 9, plus 1 times 5 times negative 1, minus 1 times 8 times 9 plus 1 times 1 times negative 1 plus 3 times 5 times 1. So if we look here, guys, they're not always going to cancel out with zeros. 8 plus 27 minus 5 minus 72 minus 1 plus 15. 30 minus, this is going to be 86. Which is going to give me negative 56. Remember, our formula is half times the absolute value of our determinant. So it's going to be half times a positive 56, which means our area is going to be 28 units squared.